going back to it, the apostles and elders, a great millstone, but who are the men who are deemed worthy? Those are the vessels that Yahweh Shem Yahushua chosen to push forth His word in honesty and truth, breaking down things to the simplest forms. And if you can't get it, then it's like, I can't help you. I can't show you any other way to get to know how what I'm talking about, what the scriptures is talking about.
Yeah, man. Hey, does somebody have that in Timothy, the fourth chapter?
I got it. So the fourth or the fifth?
The fourth chapter.
Or 16. Yeah, you can start up at 6 though. Yeah.
16.
No, go. I got it. 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 16. Take heed unto thyself and unto the doctrine.
Take heed to yourself and to the doctrine. Talk about the doctrine that you learned, man.
Yep.
All right.
It says, continue in them, for in doing so, thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee.
See, if you would stick with the doctrine, hey, you can save yourself, man.
In the end.
If you endure in the doctrine unto the end, you can save yourself, man. And those that hear you. But now you killing people. You making sure, Jake, that listen, that come up under you, you making sure they don't have a shot for salvation, man. You know? That's what you're doing. And that's the reason why once you leave from this thing and you start switching up the doctrine, we don't want no parts with you, man. You ain't no brother, man.
Yeah, you scattering
the sheep, man.
Yeah,
right. And the scriptures say, matter of fact, Second John, verse starting at verse 9. When you leave off from the doctrine, man, that's pretty much it, man.
Got it.
Yeah.
This is 2 John, verse 9. Whosoever transgresseth and abideth not in the doctrine of Yahweh's Son hath not Yahweh.
Hey, you don't have the Father. Hey, so for you to claim that the Father is directly dealing with you, but you teaching the off doctrine, that proves you're a liar. Okay? If you don't have the doctrine of Yahweh's Shai, the true doctrine, by which the spirit, the doctrine of Yahweh's Shai rests with great millstone, man.
Yeah.
If you don't have the doctrine, then the Father is not with you. Okay, and the word transgress in this context doesn't actually mean to break a law. And to prove, matter of fact, somebody got a phone? Somebody go on the blue letter and look up, go to 2 John 1 and 9 and look up the word transgress. Transgressing. And Sakari, he tried to bring this scripture out, was that last year? When he was out there in New York, and he tried to use that to say that as long as they're not transgression and they all believe the doctrine, you know, they're basically, if they keep the commandments, then, you know, they're brothers. Nah, man. When they talk about transgress, that ain't talking about breaking the commandments in this context. That's talking about if you leave off from the doctrine. If you teach a total, completely different doctrine than the doctrine that you came under, that you learned from. Okay? 2 John 1 and 9. The word transgressive.
What's up?
Huh?
We're looking for the one in that particular verse.
In that verse.
Because he has the app. That's the app. Right?
Yeah, read it again.
This is 2 John, verse 9. Whosoever transgresseth and abideth not in the doctrine of Yahweh Shai hath not Yahweh.
Uh-huh.
He that abideth in the doctrine of Yahweh Shai, he both the Father and the Son.
Yeah, if you stick with the doctrine, with the true doctrine, you have the Father and the Son. All right? That's when the Spirit will be working with you, man. You know? But if you leave off from the doctrine, you start switching the doctrine up, you start getting carried away about every wind of doctrine, the Father is not dealing with you. You got it? Yeah, go ahead and read the definition.
Transgression. To go aside, hence, to go beyond.
to go beside, to go beyond. Go ahead.
Chiefly used metaphorically of transgressing the tradition of the elders. The commandment of the Most High, that's in Matthew and Acts.
Read the top one.
To go aside, to go beyond.
To go beside or to go beyond.
The Greek is parabiano.
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 Yeah. So if you go beside the doctrine, then guess what? The Spirit of the Father is not going to sup with you, man. All right? I believe the actual Greek word for, it's a different Greek word for the actual word transgression, which means to break the laws, man. Matter of fact, go from there and go to, First John 3 and 4, where it says, he that transgresseth the law, commit of sin. Look for the Greek word for that word, transgressing. No, you ain't gotta read it. Well, yeah, read it real quick.
This is 1 John 3 and 4. Whosoever committed sin, also, it's like, whosoever committed sin, transgresseth also the law. Yep. For sin is the transgression of the law.
Right, now let's get the Greek word for this word, transgression. You'll see that it's a different word, man.
Ohio. To do.
It says with
anomia.
Lawlessness,
right?
Mm-hmm. It's rendered transgression of the law.
Speak it louder, bro.
It's rendered transgression the law.
Transgression of the law. Was there more on the definition?
Second part, anomia. Alone.
Good job, man.
Alone is rendered transgression of the law.
That's that's the Greek word for transgression in that verse, that context. When you go back to 2 John, the first chapter, in the ninth verse, when it says, he that transgresseth and abide not in the doctrine of Yahweh Shai, that's talking about leaving off or going beyond the doctrine, man. When you start teaching shit like the flat earth, or you teaching that you don't need teachers, you know, all these different bugged out doctrines that you didn't learn from the apostles, hey, that's you're transgressing. Okay? Sakari, hey, you transgress, man. You left off from the 95% of what you teach is from the apostles. All right? But one of the things that you don't agree with is we ain't supposed to worship Yahweh Shah. All right? Hey, according to the doctrine of Yahweh Shai, because he comes in the volume of the book. All right, so according to the scripture, you are to worship Yahweh Shai. That's in the scriptures, man.
That's just stupidity, man.
You know?
That's plain, man. You should know that already, man.
Yeah, that's
the church,
easy.
The church to tell you
that's
that.
That's easy.
Yeah.
And I'm still waiting on y'all to, you know, because they did, well, I don't know if they did the homework yet. The same homework assignment that I tell you guys in ITR to do, the highest form of worship,
yeah.
Find the Greek word for it. Now, Sakari, they did the homework on that. But my challenge to them, which they never took up that challenge, they still running. If that same word that applies to the Most High, What is the Hebrew equivalent to that word?
Yeah.
Okay, and then we can go from there. Since you say that don't apply to Yahweh Shah.
Did you break that down already? Couldn't they just watch the video?
They're not gonna do it, bro.
Yeah, I know. Cause they probably have seen the video you did on.
Yeah.
You don't want to humble down.
Yeah, like SW, he saw the challenge, man.
Yeah.
And he came on the comic board and, you know, he was making all his different little arguments, but he never actually took up that challenge, man. He refused to do it. Hey, if he did do the homework, there's a reason why he didn't do the video.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
Because it's going to cut him.
That's what I'm saying.
It's going to cut y'all shit, man.
It probably did. It was like,
yeah, man.
I got something.
This is Matthew 12 and 30. He that is not with me is against me. And he that gathereth not with me scattereth abroad. So these guys that's not with Yahushua is scattering abroad the sheep, you know?
Yeah.
They're scattering the way that people that really want to learn. And then what they do, they corrupt their minds because they're blind. So if the blind leads the blind, they're both going to fall into the trap, into the ditch. You know, and that's not a good thing. You know, you don't want. Here it is. We're trying to wash the blood off our hands, and you're just taking the blood on. The Most High's going to put the blood on your hands now, because you told this man that he wasn't supposed to do the right thing, because you didn't know any better. So now that judgment's going to fall upon you, and then you're going to get more stripes. You're going to get an even worse beating than what you were supposed to get.
Right.
You know? Because that's what the scripture says.
Yeah, man.
You know? Because here it is. You have the knowledge, and you holding, you're not trying to give reverence to the right people. Or you just clearly just bucking up and just wanting to. Because look, why would you want to go do your own thing anyway? It talks about the body being this one. If you go out, if you, one individual person wants to go out and do something, like, all right, we understand to have the knowledge is beautiful, but why would you want to leave the body? Why would you want to leave the men that's in like mind with you? You know? Unless it's for a convenience of travel, I don't see why anybody would want to go do their own thing and then teach. Oh, because maybe you wasn't getting enough attention or whatever, or you don't have enough time to speak. That's just a part of the order, man. There's a lot of brothers in the camp. Maybe if the camp is big enough, you can split it into two. So then that brother can get more shine, or these brothers can get more shine. Maybe, you know.
But let me say this like you, bro. But it's not about our personal shine, man. It's about making Yahweh Baal Shemiah shine, making them shine properly. That's what it's all about. We don't get no glory down here, man.
Right.
We'll get the shine in the kingdom once we glorify them. That's when the shine will come for us. But on this side, it's all about them. When the sooner you niggas understand it's all about the Heavenly Father and His Son, the better off everybody will be.
And the only glory we get on this side is the persecution.
Right.
All the hell that you niggas put on us, all you men slandering and going on smear campaigns against GMS, really y'all glorifying, y'all helping GMS get glorified.
Yeah.
Because they're the ones that are suffering the afflictions and the persecution that the apostles and disciples suffered for teaching in the name of Yahweh Shah.
Huh.
You know? Outside of that, man, we ain't got nothing else to glory of, man. All right? We glory that we know of Yahweh Shah, you know? But it ain't of ourselves, you know? The Lord use us as, we're just His vessels, man.
We're just
vessels, man. We ain't seeking nothing, man.
We ain't shit.
We ain't shit, man. Why is ashes and earth proud, man?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Rags. Our righteousness is up 50 rags out here.
For real. He could raise up rocks, man.
Yeah.
Replace us with stones and shit, man. You know? You niggas are nobody, man.
Hey, we are rocks. We're part of that house. We're building up, we're one of those stones to that spiritual house that the Lord built.
Lively stones.
Yeah,
man. Right, hey, and we make up the great millstone.
Yeah,
right.
The apostle went into that, man.
Yahweh Shai is the chief cornerstone.
Yep.
Okay, and we make up the rest of the, you know, the bricks, man. You know? And all you do is that's coming against the great millstone. Believe it or not, you ain't gotta accept it. All right, we speak it boldly in the spirit, man. You come against great millstone, you coming against Yahweh Shai, man. Okay.
You're gonna get grounded to powder.
You're gonna get grounded to powder, man. All right. We you know, to start with the apostles on down, we represent the burdensome stone that's gonna crush your people, man. If you burden yourself with it.
This is 2 Peter 2 and 5.
No, not bad.
Not 5.
1 Peter. The live stone.
Yeah,
1 Peter.
is 1 Peter 2 and 5.
Hey, you can start at the top though.
This 1 Peter 2. Wherefore, laying aside all malice and all guile and hypocrisies and envies and all evil speaking.
Let go of all of that evil speaking, that malice, that envy, you know? That pride, let go of all of that evil speaking. Because it's vain. You know, it's for no reason. Forget, put your emotions aside.
As newborn babes desire the sincere milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby.
Yeah, desire the sincere milk that you may grow thereby. Because what do babe, you know, it's you got to humble yourself down to a babe. But some people didn't do that, Nazariah. You know, Zachary. You know, you come in here already having a high mind, and then you get built up some type of way, and then now you just think you're above the elders. You think you got more stories than the elders. You know, who are you? Who are you?
Hey, another thing that puffed these niggas up is all them subscribers.
Yep.
All them little lackey followers that they get. You know what I'm saying? Oh, I got 10,000, I got 12,000 subscribers. So I know I'm on a level.
Yeah, and those subscribers are not genuine. They're not diligent. If the apostles and elders was like to go like, look, I want all my subscribers to come to this location on this day. If you need money, blah blah blah, you know, somehow make it happen. I want all y'all come to the Passover those subscribers are going to be there. You know, I mean, at least the true and honest ones. Majority of the subscribers are going to be there.
The majority of your subscribers subscribe to entertainment. That's why they hit the subscribe button. They watch you because they like the fuckery and the drama that ensues within, you know, the truth, man.
Yep.
All right, they like to watch you because they like how your intro start with your little graphics and your little, you know. They like all that shit, man. And then when they see that you getting ready to go into somebody, you know, like for example, you try to you going into what's the brother in ATL, you know what I'm saying, about him you know, I guess standing next to Young Thug or whatever. So you trying to make the whole congregation look bad, you trying to talk down upon us, and you doing that because you know everybody's gonna tune in and it's gonna get you a lot of hits. And we can't forget you niggas monetize your videos.
Oh yeah.
So we see the hidden agenda behind what you niggas do, man. You know, it ain't genuine. And the niggas that are under you or the niggas that watch you, they're not genuine, man. I'll say 9,000 of your subscribers, Alizé, are from the Black Unconscious community.
Yeah.
All the niggas that subscribe to what's
on this?
Black News 102. Yeah. You know, Sonnetter TV, you know, Brother Polite, you know.
Brother No Light.
No Light. Them same individuals is who subscribe to you, man. You know, let alone all the niggas that hate GMS. Yakko and his 80 accounts, they all subscribe to you.
Because we know that you're really looking at the whole subscriber game as a number game that it really is.
Yeah, man.
You know, because two-thirds of Israel way more outnumber the elect. This is more than double the elect. So you gonna go where the numbers are. It's like, you know, if you want to pass out your CD, well, you ain't gonna go where there's 10 people at. You gonna go where there's the big crowds at.
Yeah. And we and it ain't a numbers game to us. We already know the number that's gonna be sealed.
144.
Okay. That's why we don't care about how many views we get and how many subscribers we have, man. Okay? We're just pushing the word. Whoever ears it fall upon, it falls upon.
Right.
Okay? We ain't doing this for the entertainment of niggas that wanna be entertained. We leave that to you niggas that's seeking your own vainglory.
Right.
You
right.
want attention. Yeah, go ahead. Let's go back to the scripture.
This 1 Peter 2 and 2, as newborn babes desire the sincere milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby.
Yeah, grown by from the milk.
If so be ye have tasted that the Most High is gracious.
Yeah, the Most High is gracious. You know, because Like hey, the brother, like the brother said, our righteousness is as filthy rags, you know? Yeah. Technically, we're supposed to be put to death, most of us, you know?
Yeah. He's gracious to us.
Yeah, man, and it's a beautiful, and I praise Yahweh Shem Yahushua, you know?
Love it.
Yeah, you know, I give all praises to Yahweh Shem Yahushua for letting me be able to, you know, still push this work. You know, I have all fingers, you know, have my eyes, I have feet to walk, you know, to push this work. I just praise him, just, you know, like, because he's so merciful. Man, I don't, you know,
yeah.
There's a lot of things that we don't need that, you know, that he gives us. And it's, you know, we just take the water.
Yep.
Yeah. To whom coming as unto a living stone, disallowed indeed of men, but chosen of Yahweh.
Hey, disallowed of men. Basically, those wicked scribes and Pharisees, they're the builders that rejected the chief cornerstone. All the men that were coming against Yahweh Shai back then, they're going to be coming against Yahweh Shai today. And Yahweh Shai is not here on the earth. But you have men who he set up that he has on the earth that's coming in his stead, that's teaching his doctrine. If you're coming against those men, you rejected the chief cornerstone. Read that part again.
To whom coming as unto a living stone, disallowed indeed of men.
Disallowed indeed of men. Go ahead.
But chosen of Yahweh and precious.
But it's chosen of the Most High and precious. Okay? Yahweh Shai is precious, man. Okay? And then the elect, the ones that are under, the ones that are the first fruits unto Yahweh Shai, they're also precious, and it's getting ready to tell you. Go ahead.
Ye also, as lively stones, are built up a spiritual house,
yep,
and holy priesthood, to offer us spiritual sacrifices acceptable to Yahweh by Yahweh Shai.
Yeah, read that again.
Ye also, as lively stones, are built up a spiritual house and holy priesthood to offer up spiritual sacrifices. Ye also as lively stones.
Lively stones. We're building up that spiritual house. You know, here it is. But we'll take Babylon. Break that word down. Babylon, which means confusion. You know, then tell the people that this place is built is based off Babylon. You know, and then also other kingdoms. You guys are living in spiritual Babylon, Egypt, and Sodom and Gomorrah. You know, let's say of the scriptures. And that's, you know, we take that word Babylon, like I said, break it down. What do you mean? Which means confusion. You know, this confusion, this place is nothing but filled with confusion. Here it is, we have men trying to dress like women, also trying to do sex changes. That's confusing. When you go to an establishment, you think you're talking to a woman, and then it's actually a man. With some men, it's actually type disgusting, and you feel defiled. I mean that at least me, you know? Yeah, it vexes my soul greatly. You know?
Like Lot. Just like Lot.
Yeah, just like Lot. You know, then also what we have? We have little children trying to be like little girls and boys trying to change their sex. And this is all just those spirits that's waxing worse and worse. Cause these people are starting to really to suck that Babylon juice down, you know, and really fully digesting them. That's why a lot of people gonna have to die on this side. Because they've been indulging too much in that Babylon juice already.
Slap y'all. I don't know if y'all seen the little white girl who won the wrestling championship.
Yeah, I saw that.
And she been taking steroids. Testosterone.
Yeah.
And they letting her do it.
Yeah.
Letting her wrestle with performance enhancing drugs.
Because they were trying to say that she, they would have an advantage of her. They'll take advantage of her because it's a woman, even though. She's been changed into a man.
But she's taking advantage of the other girls because now she on testosterone, which none of them have.
Yeah, that's all wickedness, man.
Yeah, that's fucking confusion, man.
If you heard the interview, she sounded just like a little boy.
Yeah.
Then she got muscles, triceps and shit.
Yeah.
I'm like, look at this shit.
Yeah, man.
That's wicked. Esau ain't shit.
Hey, but, you know, that's some of the things that the men of the Lord are going to sigh and cry about.
Yeah.
That's the different abominations that the men of the Lord are going to sigh and cry, you know, in the midst thereof, man.
Yeah.
All right? Now, hey, you other guys, you ain't sighing and crying about that type of shit. you signed a cry out crying about great millstone.
Uh-huh.
All right, so we know that angel ain't finna seal that mark within you niggas.
In 1 Peter 2 and 5, ye also as lively stones are built up a spiritual house and holy priesthood to offer us spiritual sacrifices acceptable to Yahweh by Yahweh Shai.
Yeah, we're offering up spiritual sacrifices unto Yahweh Shai, you know, to make sure that our sacrifices are deemed worthy. You know, we come out here, sacrifice our time, you know, we also sacrifice our time by studying, reviewing things constantly.
Making videos.
Yeah, making videos. You know, dealing with amongst the Akim.
Yeah, Romans 12. Give your bodies as a living sacrifice.
Yep. Hey, sacrificing our personal lives, yep, time with our family. I mean, there's a lot of things that we sacrifice. But for what? To make it and not catch the destruction.
12,
Romans
1. Yeah. This is Romans chapter 12, verse 1. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of the Most High, that ye present your bodies as a living sacrifice.
Yeah, present our bodies as a living sacrifice. Some of us, some brothers, apostles and elders that come out here, we push the word with certain ailments, bad knees, hips, and backs, necks, you know, looking down at the computer screen or our swords while we're reading, it gets a little cramped up, you know. So we're sacrificing our achy bodies. We're also sacrificing our some of our families just to you know, to push the word for Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. Because that's what he told us to do.
Right. So that's, we compromise our life, man. Yeah. We compromise everything, man, for this truth.
And it's worth it.
And it's worthy for that penny that we're gonna get at the end of it, man. You know?
We count
everything dumb, man. Okay? So we give our bodies as a living sacrifice. And all the caps all throughout the world represent altars. Okay, right here, GMS Vegas. In this cap, this is the altar of Yahweh Shai in Vegas.
Right.
The altar of Yahweh, why Yahweh Shai in Vegas.
Right.
Are the brothers in LA, GMS Ancient of Days? Hey, that's the altar of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai in LA.
Right.
All right, New York, the main camp, and all the other camps, man. All you see all the brothers standing out there putting their lives on the line to preach this word, man.
Great boldness.
And great boldness, man.
Right.
All right, without the spirit of fear. Okay? We don't care if people come up and threaten us. You know, they try to come and harm us. You know, nothing gonna move the men of the Lord. That's why it says in Isaiah 30, I will not suffer thy teachers to be removed into a corner anymore. The teachers are not gonna be removed. All right? Your eyes are gonna see your teachers. Back to that in Peter, real quick.
This is 2 Peter 2 and 5. Ye also as lively stones are built up a spiritual house.
Matter of fact, start at 4 again.
This is 2 Peter 2 and 4. To whom coming as unto a living stone, disallowed indeed of men, but chosen of Yahweh and precious.
Yeah, that stone is talking about Yahweh Shai. Okay?
Yeah.
And it said precious too. Go from there to 1 Peter 1 to show you that the elect is also precious.
This is 1 Peter 1 and 7. That the trial of your faith, being much more precious than of gold that perisheth, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Yahweh Shai.
Hold on. Yeah, that honor and that glory appearing to unto Yahweh Shai. You know? That we wanna be honorable servants or vessels unto Yahweh Shai when he comes back.
This is 1 Peter 1:7. That the trial of your faith being much more precious than of gold that perisheth, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise.
Hey, even though we go through all these tribulations and afflictions and so on and so forth, the glory and the gift that you get from this, that you know, is way more precious than anything else. Hey, seeing the fall of your enemies, being of those 12 thrones, judging the house of Israel, the 12 tribes of Israel, all of those things are precious, man. Getting out of.
Can't put a value on it. Can't put a price tag on none of that.
Right. Being a joint heir with Yahweh Shai, all that's precious, man. All that's precious. To be in good favor of Yahweh, the Most High God, that's precious. The Creator, to be on the good graces of the Creator, that's precious, man. Was it more there or no?
Though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Yahweh Shai Mashiach.
That's pertaining to the elect. They're going to be found precious. They're going to be found tried and refined. You niggas, y'all not tried and refined yet, man. All right. Matter of fact, you're not refined at all.
Yeah,
because you didn't stand the test. You didn't maintain your integrity, man. You left off from the doctrine. Okay? Yeah, go back. There's a little more there.
Though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Yahweh Shai, whom having not seen, ye love in whom. Though now ye see him not, yet believing, ye rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory, receiving the end of your faith, even the salvation of your souls.
Yeah, man, and that's talking about that day when Yahweh Shai comes back and deliver his elect from the four winds. Those men are going to be found worthy, man.
That's right.
They're the elect. They're precious in the sight of the Heavenly Father. All right? You know? And we pray that we're those men. That's why we're doing the things that we're doing now. That's why we're defending the gospel, man. All right? Well, you got some niggas that already said that they already tried and refined. You know? Go from there to, go back to Peter 2:6.
This is 1 Peter 2:6. Wherefore, also it is contained in the scripture, behold, I lay in Zion a chief cornerstone, elect, precious, and he that believeth on him shall not be confounded.
Yeah, he that believeth on him shall not be confounded. That's talking about Yahweh Shai, man. Okay? He's that stone. All right? Go ahead.
Unto you, therefore, which believe, he is precious, but unto them which be disobedient, the stone.
They that be disobedient, you rebellious children that refuse to obey, man. All right? That refuse to obey. Okay? You're being disobedient to Yahweh Shai, man, by coming up against the men that he set up. Read that part again.
Wherefore also it is contained in the scripture, behold, I lay in Zion a chief cornerstone, elect, precious, and he that believeth on him shall not be confounded. Yep. Unto you, therefore, which believe, he is precious. But unto them which be disobedient, the stone which the builder disallowed, the same is made the head of the corner.
That's it, man. You know? When you come up against that stone, it's gonna grind you up. All right? You come against the great millstone, you're gonna get grinded up, man. Okay? That's what's gonna happen to you.
It's into powder, right?
Yeah. You know? Matter of fact, that's what's that in
did it on the video just the other
day. I know, I did it too.
Yeah.
I believe it's in Matthew, man.
I just did it too.
They said they're gonna be broken pieces.
They're gonna be grinded.
No, that one didn't say it. No. But it's one in Matthew though.
I'll bring this up.
This is get Acts 4 and 10 and 11. Acts 4, 10 through 11. And all you niggas are basically making manifest that you were the men that was coming up against Yahweh Shai 2,000 years ago.
4 and 11.
All right,
Matthew
4 and 11. Yeah, start
Acts.
Acts.
Acts 11.
I'm gonna start at
Matthew
10
first. 21 and 45. Matthew 21:45.
Acts 4 and 11.
That's what I'm.
This is the stone which was set.
No, start at 10.
This Acts 4 and 10, be it known unto you all, and to all the people of Israel, that by the name of Yahweh Shah HaMashiach of Nazareth, whom he crucified, whom Yahweh raised from the dead, even by him doeth this man stand before you whole.
All right, go ahead.
This is the stone which was set at naught of you builders, which has become the head of the corner.
That's right. He's the stone, all right, that you builders rejected. And when you go into, when he was talking about the scribes and Pharisees, he told them that parable. You still got that, right? Yeah. Go on and get it.
Matthew 21 and 42. It says, Yahweh Shai said unto them.
Hey, brother, brother.
Oh, my bad.
It said, Matthew 21 and 42. Yahweh Shai saith unto them, did ye never read in the scriptures? And the stone which the builders rejected, the same has become the head of the corner.
Uh-huh.
This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes.
Yep.
Therefore I say unto you, the kingdom of the Most High, Yahweh, shall be taken from you and given to a nation bringing forth the fruits thereof.
And that's the reason why the Lord basically took his understanding from those reprobates,
yeah,
and he just pushed the gospel to his men.
Yeah. That's how he made those Jews jealous.
He basically went to the elects, man.
Yeah.
And you had among the Israelite foreigners, the men that Paul went to, there was an elect in those churches, man.
Yeah.
All right, the Spirit worked with them and they was able to get it. But them wicked scribes and Pharisees, the ones who want to sit up in the upper room in the chief seats, they want to be seen of men, they want to exalt themselves and get the preeminence. Hey, the Lord wasn't, the understanding wasn't given to them. Why? Because they rejected the Lord. They rejected that corner, man. You know? So when you reject Yahweh Shai, the Lord reject the understanding from you, okay? By default, you can't get this if Yahweh Shai didn't deem you as one of his men or his elect.
Right.
All right, to prove that, Isaiah 8.
There's more on this.
Okay.
Verse 44.
Isaiah 8.
It says, and whosoever shall fall on this stone shall be broken.
But what? Wait, what?
It said, and whosoever shall fall on this stone shall be broken.
Yeah, you fall upon that stone, you're going to get broken up, man.
Uh-huh.
You know?
But on whomsoever it shall fall, it will grind him to powder.
Hey, mm-hmm. It's going like a millstone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's going to grind you up, man. Well, we got some Jesus freaks.
Yeah.
May I ask you a question?
Yeah.
In what name do you come in, and what's your doctrine?
We shine for the creator of my universe and world. Created all of us. We're to love all men and love him.
Well, you love all men? And where do you get that ideology? Is that out of the Bible or?
My relationship with him.
Oh, so it's just with your own? It's just with your own heart? That's out of your own heart? That's out of your own heart, right?
Yeah.
Do you believe in the Bible?
Oh, yes, of course.
Yeah. Okay, well, you know what the scriptures say about the heart, right?
Right.
Get that real quick. Jeremiah 17 and 9. Real quick. This is in the prophets. Go ahead.
This is Jeremiah 17, verse 9. And the heart
the heart is deceitful above all things.
Yep.
Okay, and this
is you agree with that. That the heart is deceitful, right?
Yes.
And desperately wicked. So, who can know it?
So basically what you're saying, does that tie up with the scriptures? About loving mankind, loving everybody, and the Lord is for the universe and all that. Is that scriptural?
In my relationship, he tells me love all men. Number one, love him. And then number two, love all men.
According to the scripture?
Yeah, of course.
Can you provide me a scripture that proves that particular saying?
I'm not that affluent with it, unfortunately. That's not what I'm right now.
Love one another is because I loved you.
Did you love did your foreparents love the so-called Native Americans and Latino and so-called Negroes when they came to this land?
All I know is the way this freaking government going sucks. That's all I know.
Yeah,
dude, that's your government.
Right.
If they just put all that money into just loving and caring about everybody, yeah. And I mean,
who'd you vote for?
This shit around us is such a good example of the greed and the money. Where's the homeless shelter, man? Where's that?
Who'd you vote for?
They should have one of them just as big.
Can I ask you one more question?
Uh huh.
Since you say love, this, you see these images?
Yeah.
Was this an act of love?
It doesn't matter if it's a black man, it doesn't matter who it is. That's never an act of God.
That is an act of God. That is not
an act of God.
That was an act of God.
Well, everything happens for a reason.
Why you running?
The wicked fled with no man pursuing.
That's what that was about.
God would never do that, though.
Hey, the wicked flee when no man pursues.
This is the God they were thinking of, and this is exactly what he does.
Yeah.
This is who did that, you know?
They didn't want to stay, they didn't want to get cut. That's what
it was too hot, it was getting too hot.
That looks like,
that was that, that rain was being sprayed and the roaches had to scatter.
Right, right.
They didn't even stick around long enough to get their judgment.
Right.
They got
They got it.
Right.
God wouldn't do that. Are you serious?
They got their judgment.
Yeah.
They ain't gonna wear them shirts together no more.
You know how many scriptures we could have pulled on that's not, God didn't do that, that's not an act of God.
Right.
The Most High,
This is Isaiah 45:7. I form the light and create darkness. I make peace and create evil. I, the Lord, Yahweh, do all these things.
There's so many scriptures we can go to prove the Most High did that.
Hey, but you know what? That just proves that these people in the world are totally just bugged out. They just follow after shit. They got on shirts that says Jesus, and they claim that they believe in the Bible, but they don't know anything in the scriptures.
We got one script.
They don't even know no scriptures, man.
Yeah, I know what that
showing
is.
You religion is bullshit.
Yep.
These people don't know what they following, man. They just following what the world do. But really, that's an Edomite. And Edomites, they're the ones that control the world. What I'm saying?
But that's how we know what the mother groups, Nathan, is trying to find.
If you juiced in with these people, right. Hey, come on, man.
You getting connected to scattering the sheep. Just like the Edomites scattering the flock, man.
Yeah,
you getting caught in with that because you allowing that BS to go on. When you pushing the name Jesus Christ, when you pushing that he loves everybody, or you pushing that the earth is flat, or whatever. Any way that's off from the true understanding of this scripture, you going off, man. You pushing that another Jesus, man. You pushing another Savior.
Yeah, you pushing Jesus, man. Hey, that was a prime example right there. That Edomite couple, they push Jesus too.
God would never do that.
You know?
She thought she knew more than he knew.
Yeah.
And he agreed with him. And they both was way up.
Yeah, man, let's go back though. Let's go back into what we was just going into, man. You know, we had to put them on the spot.
It's fun to do that to people that think they know the Lord and the Bible. Well, it's in my mind that I got it figured out. He told me.
Right.
He that's inside me. He made me to understand that. Okay, sure. What does it say that? In my heart. Okay, let's see what the scripture says. Yeah, the only way we know about the Selah, the only way we know about the Most High God, and Yahweh Shai, the Lord, is through his book. There's no other way that you can know what they're thinking or what they're about but through this book.
Yeah. Yeah, man. And then you got to be an Israelite too.
Proper understanding from an Israelite with this book.
Yeah, man. Yeah, let's go back. I think I have Brothers Poole.
Yeah, I read that powder script, the last one I read.
Yeah, read that again.
The last verse. It said, and I'm going to start up at 43. It says, it's Matthew 21 and 43. Therefore I say unto you, the kingdom of the Most High, I'm going to start at the top of 42. It says, Yahweh Shai said unto them, did ye never read in the scriptures? The stone which the builders rejected, the same has become the head of the corner.
Yep.
And when Yahweh Shai was on the scene, right?
Yep.
It says, this is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. Yeah, it is marvelous in our eyes. Therefore I say unto you, the kingdom of the Most High shall be taken from you. That's when the more kingdom, excellent ministry comes in. Right. And I don't want all the Jews. I don't want the two-thirds, the whole congregation. I just want the sincere ones of the elect, my chosen.
Yeah, according to the scriptures, the kingdom of heaven starts with the knowledge.
Yep.
This knowledge, this understanding that we have, that's the kingdom of the Most High.
And when you reject Yahweh Shai, the
knowledge ain't going to come to you. You're not worthy of the knowledge.
Yeah.
Even if you get the knowledge, if you're not of the Lord's elect, he's gonna withdraw it from you. Yeah. Much like all you niggas that fell out over the years, man.
Yeah.
Okay, he took the kingdom of heaven from you. Now you gotta die to get into the kingdom now.
Nathan didn't reject the Howard Shah. They would reject that corner. Because they won't use the name in the proper Hebrew.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. So you rather push Christ Christ, God bless Christ, whatever you want to say, you know? No, man, that's not his name. You got to call upon his name in the right spirit. If not, you're rejecting it, man.
Yep.
It says, therefore I said to you, the kingdom of the Most High shall be taken from you and given to a nation bringing forth the fruits thereof.
That's talking about the elect.
Yep.
The ones that's going to take the word. They're going to take in the word, and they're going to be fruitful with the word.
Yep.
They're going to bring in fruit. They're going to go for the fruit that's going to remain.
Yep.
The ones that are meet for repentance, man. They're going to grow in the word. All that, man. That's who the Lord was going to give this knowledge to, man. Okay? Keep going, Doc.
Yep, it says, and whosoever shall fall on this stone shall be broken.
Yep, go ahead.
But on whomsoever it shall fall, it will grind him to powder.
That's gonna grind you to powder, man. Meaning you're gonna get cut to shreds coming up against that spirit, coming up against Yahweh Shai, coming up against the wisdom. You're gonna get cut to shreds, man. And then you're rejected. Alright? You basically, if you're a reprobate, hey. You fit those people that were grounded to powder, man.
Yep.
Okay. Yep.
2 Timothy 2 and 1. Thou therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Yahweh Shai Mashiach.
Yep.
And the thing that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men who shall be able to teach others. Because it was taken from, and that's to, it was given to the elect that would be able to teach others. And it was taken from you that knew your Israel.
The circumcision.
The other circumcision, and it was taken from you.
Yeah, those were the wicked scribes and Pharisees, man. You know, you have some righteous Pharisees that believed. Yeah. Right, not every Pharisee was wicked.
Right.
But you had the wicked Pharisees.
Yeah.
The ones that were being hypocrites.